Well, this is where we're at with tiling the bathroom. The last bits of the walls being done. Got to remove that light fitting, the old light fitting, and fill that old Petska hole from the wood burning shower. The ceiling, believe it or not, has been cleaned. Karen's cleaned it a couple of times to try and get all the soot off the paint. And we're going to paint the upper half and above the tiles in a white waterproof paint, purely because it's a lot of faff trying to cut in for these, and figured we might as well end it all at the same height. So I think tomorrow Karen's going to get loose with doing the grout. So it's not perfect, but we're dealing with walls that aren't quite perfect. And I'm not an expert tiler, so we're just trying to improve things as we go. Today we've had some sand and gravel delivered, and several bags of cement. And over there in the background behind the mixer, there's the reinforcing wire as well. So that's ready for hopefully a warm day, and then we can get concrete in the living room. We managed to get the levels done for either side of the room, ready for concrete in the floor. The viscreen will have to wait till Monday, the plastic. Got to pick some more of that up from the shop. So we're getting somewhere towards it, just praying for a bit warmer temperatures, else we won't be able to concrete. So, but yeah, moving along ever so slowly. There's all the cement that we've got ready for the floor. Yeah, going through a bit, but it's all in a good cause. We've got Karen in the bathroom, removing all the adhesive in between the tiles that's squished up before she can do any grouting. So, going all right, sweetie?
It is going all right, slowly but all right.
Okie dokie. Yeah, got a fair bit of cleaning to do. And the grout's a nice pretty colour.
Ocean blue.
Ocean blue, okay. Yeah, can't wait to see that in. Well done, baby.
Yeah.
Subtitles. Hello. Right, say bye.
Bye.
This is the tiles, all cleaned, mostly cleaned anyway. Ready for grouting next. Karen's just reading up on the mix. Here's our chief grouter coming to start our mission.
Blue.
Okay. Nice blue compared to the tiles, isn't it?
Please.
Like that. That's a good job, actually.
Yes, because we know most people would have gone for white or black, but.
No.
That's most people.
Indeed. Right, I'll leave you to it.
So that's the job so far. Camera's just wiped all the excess off and just done that corner and this end wall. A bit of a bigger gap there where the wall's actually lent out. Not a lot we could do about that, to be fair. It was never a square wall to start off with, and I think we've done probably
pretty damn good.
Yeah, probably as better than we imagined.
And a good morning to everybody. Lovely sunny day again, and I'm going to be inside doing the grouting. So this is the colour we got. Like a ocean. I stupidly did think it was ready mixed stuff because I'm lazy, but it isn't. So there's a quarter of the mixture. I did a quarter yesterday because you've got to work it within 2 hours of mixing, which me being menopausal and such and easily distracted is probably slightly impossible. So I've been working out quarter measures of everything and trusty wooden spoon for mixing. Here we go. I think I put a tiny bit too much water in here, so we'll put all of it in. That's how it goes. Yesterday it was just starting to dry up a little bit by the time I finished, so I think I got the mixture about right. They're going to cracks without actually falling back out again. Cracks. Spaces in the tiles, obviously. Right, so here goes. I'll show you how sunny it is out here. Considering this is the end of October. Look at this. We've got a dodgy battery on the van. So Phil's just messing about with electrics to sort that out. Look at his happy little face, bless him. So off we go. Right, so into here. Devil's hole. All dark and stuff. Put the light on. There you go. Yay! This is the bit that I did yesterday. Whee! Holes in it or anything like that. So I'll start the bits that I ran out of grout for, which you can't see because it's too dark in here with this light. So I'll leave it for now and show you what I achieve later on. Bye.
I know what I'm getting filled so, right now.
So Karen has been grouting with blue grout. Can you tell?
Actually, I don't think I'm as bad as I thought I would be.
No, so I've got a smear for a wife.
There's worse things. Hulk for a husband.
I know what you mean with that. Yeah. Smurfy. And then autumn started. But it's a bit cooler day today for us. Leaves are falling off the trees now and it's about 11 degrees outside. So I'm inside doing a job that's in need of doing before we finish walls off. And it's to fill the holes in left behind from the wood burning shower that was in the bathroom. I've filled the bathroom one in so far and the one above my head. The other direction, hang on, flip you around. Pulled that one in as well, that was above the lamb oven. And the next job on the list, while I'm waiting for these to go off a little bit and skim them, is there's a hole at the back there. that used to let rats through onto this roof. So I'm going to jam some stuff into there and concrete that as well, just to try and seal it off. It's already been concreted above, so I want to just make sure they don't even find a hole at this end if they do get down under there again. So that's the next job on the list.
Stop them chilling. I've got enough stuff here just to fill this hole in. Some broken tiles in there, something chewing, hopefully. You can put glass in as well, but these are to hand. Just to stop them from chewing through the mud. Bricks. Should deter them at least.
Next job on the list is to fill the hole from the Jamal flue and also the I guess the entrance to the Jamal when it was here. So I've got to brick that up today, just put a layer of mortar down and I'll start filling those up now. Job I'm going to tackle today is to have a go repairing this gaping hole in the end of the barn. It's right above the kindling. So they're Turkish tiles, don't like the look of them, but I'm going to have to stick with them because replacing this roof is going to cost thousands and thousands. So a repair is where we're at. We'd have the money for that kind of thing.
Start by taking these from the top, apparently. Very easily crack these tiles, very fragile. Luckily, we kept a pile of these for roof repairs laid around the land, so taking a handful of those to replace some broken ones. Okay, so this is the piece that's broken from there up to there, so I don't need to take any more tiles off, I don't think. And I haven't found a piece of timber that'll do the job.
Just reached that last bit of tile. Give me a sec.
Right at the very top of my ladders.
And let's see how big a mess I can make here. Okay. Oh, shit. That was a crack. Yeah, very fragile. So, need to make a new one of these. And not quite sure I'm going to fasten everything, but we'll get to it.
More reshaping done at the top. We'll see how this goes. Wish me luck.
Bit of timber cut. The biggest challenge I've got is shaping it at each end so it meets up with the slope. I think I'm all right, but only time will tell, I guess.
Right, I go from wide to tapered, sitting into a wide to tapered on the way down, and then the top ones go from tapered to wide, sat in each gully. The trick is you've got to work your way that way to make it work right, so you've got to work up to the ridge. So I'm not quite sure I'm going to do that yet, but we'll see how it goes. Tricky.
I worked out a way of laying the tiles from the top downwards to save me standing on fresh laid tiles.
But as long as I cover the holes, then there'll be no gaps for the water to wear things away.
That's repair done. It's about as good as the rest of the roof, to be fair. I've just repaired one over here as well. Just replaced the tile that is underneath all of this lot because it was falling through. And I'm going to do this end while I'm here. Purely because it's going to hit the timber underneath, so, and maybe that one as well. Yeah, I'll do them both.
Okay, that's the roof repair done. Got no hole there now. And I've repaired about another four different places where broken roof tiles would have leaked onto the timber. So that should help them a little bit. There's a bit of that corner. Might just slot a tile under there so the timber's not exposed while I'm on with the job. So, no more untidy than the rest of it.
Right, I'm having a roofing day today, I think. So we're in the big house loft area now, and right up that tile there, there's a crack that's been weeping in. So after we did the chimney removal with Danny, I worked out that the tiles were quite easy to remove once he'd shown me. So I'm going to have a go at removing this one and replacing it, because there's a few stacked around that I can do a repair with.
This is one advantage of not having felt on a roof, I guess.
The biggest thing to watch out for when you're replacing the tiles, no matter what tiles are laid around the property, there are differences, and some roofs are a mismatch, but on these there's one seam running down here and that matches with that one. Some of them have a double seam there and obviously don't sit correctly, so it'll send your roof all over the place. And there are some with waves, and these ones are more of a square edge to them. It's just little differences like that. I mean, luckily these have a few spare tiles in the loft, and I'm able to do the repair with it, so nice one. The tail I've just replaced, just lifting the two above it up and slotting this one out, slot the new one in, and then drop these two down. So fairly simple. Right, I'll have a good wander around and see what else I can replace.